Today we're going to learn how to find the midpoint. Suppose we have two points. Then the midpoint is the point that's halfway between these two, which would be somewhere around there. But before we learn how to find the midpoint, let's do a quick review about averages and means. Recall that to compute the average of some numbers, you simply add them together and divide by how many numbers there are. The average is also called the mean. And in this context, the word mean doesn't mean like, I am mean to people. It's a different meaning of this word, and it refers to the average. Let's see a few examples, and then we'll come back and discuss midpoints. Example 1. What is the mean, or what is the average, of negative 3 and 10? All we need to do is add these numbers together and then divide by the number of numbers. So we have negative 3 plus 10, and since there's two numbers, we divide by 2. That gives us 7 halves. Or if you want to write it as a decimal, you can write it as 3.5. So this is how you find the average of two numbers. Add them together, divide by 2. And you can find the average of more than two numbers. For example, let's find the average of 158. This time there's three numbers, so we add them together and divide by 3. So that gives us 1 plus 5 plus 8 divided by 3, or 14/3. And if you want, you can break this up and write it as 4 2/3. Or if you want, you can write it as 4 and 6 repeating. These are just different ways to write the same number. And let's see one more. This time we'll take the average, or we'll compute the mean, of four numbers. Negative 1, 7, negative 4, and 6. So we just combine them all together, add them all together, which means we're going to take a negative 1 plus 7 plus negative 4 plus 6. And since there's four numbers, we're going to divide by 4. So now we just add these all together, and that gives us 8/4, which is 2. So the mean of these four numbers is 2. Now that we've reminded ourselves of what the average is, let's now talk about how to find the midpoint. In the beginning, we learned that the midpoint is that point that's halfway between two other points. Suppose we have these two points here. Then the midpoint would be somewhere around here. Another way that you can think about the midpoint is that the midpoint bisects the line, or cuts the line segment connecting these two points in half. So if you were to draw the line segment connecting both of these endpoints, the midpoint is the bisector. It cuts it in half. So let's see some examples now. Let's find the midpoint between 5, 2, and 1, 0. Let's say the point 5, 2 is around there, and the point 1, 0 is around here. Then the midpoint should be somewhere around here. And we're going to put that there as a check. So when we compute the midpoint, we'll look to see if that is around where that x is. So to find the midpoint, all you do is take the average of the x-coordinates and the average of the y-coordinates. So first, we'll find the average of 5 and 1, the two x-coordinates, and that gives us 5 plus 1 over 2. And then we compute the average of the y-coordinates, 2 and 0. That gives us 2 plus 0 divided by 2. 5 plus 1 over 2 is 3. And 2 plus 0 is 2, divided by 2 is 1. So the midpoint of these two points is 3, 1. Let's see another example. Let's find the point halfway between negative 3, 2, and 5, negative 1. Like before, I'll draw where these two points are, approximately. Let's suppose that negative 3, 2 is right around here, and that 5, negative 1 is somewhere around there. So we're finding the point halfway between these two. That's just another way of describing the midpoint. And like before, we're going to compute the average of the x-coordinates and the average of the y-coordinates. First, we'll compute the average of the x-coordinates. We just take negative 3 plus 5 and divide by 2 because there's two numbers. And then we combine or add together the y-coordinates. That gives us 2 minus 1 divided by 2. And if we simplify these calculations, we get an x-coordinate of 1 and a y-coordinate of 1/2. And let's draw that on the plane to see if it passes the smell test. 1.5 would be somewhere around here, and that looks about right. So this is the midpoint, or the point halfway between those two. Now, sometimes you'll see people describe the midpoint, or how to compute the midpoint, by giving you the midpoint formula. And they give this to you as if it's something that you really have to memorize and imprint in your mind. And here is how the midpoint formula is usually given. Suppose you have one point P, and it has x and y coordinates, and which we'll call them x1 and y1. That way we don't have to use too many different letters. We'll start to number them with little subscripts. And let's say we have a second point Q, and its coordinates are x2 and y2. We saw earlier that to find the midpoint, we just compute the averages. So we can write that down. The midpoint is the sum of the x's divided by 2, and the y-coordinate is y1 plus y2 over 2. And this here, this expression, is what a lot of people will call the midpoint formula. What's underlying this formula is not very complicated. You're just computing two averages. And when you understand the idea behind the midpoint, that you're averaging coordinates, it allows you to do something that's really kind of fun. You can go into different dimensions. Let's start off with one-dimensional space. This is also known as the real number line. So let's go ahead and just label a few numbers. Suppose we want to find the number that's halfway between 2 and 9. So we're now in one-dimensional space, so these two points only have a single coordinate. So you could think of the point P as just 2, a single coordinate. Here, I'm using parentheses like we did with the points in the plane. Normally, people don't do that. But I'm doing this to just help conjure up your imagination that you can think of these numbers as points. And 9, we could call that point Q. And so we have two points. What we saw before was the midpoint formula for points in the plane. Here, we have points on the real number line, one-dimensional space. Well, the idea is the same. So to find the midpoint, we just add the coordinates. And in this example, the coordinates are the numbers themselves. So we just take 2 plus 9, divide by 2, because we're averaging them together. And that gives us 11/2, which is 5.5. And that would be right here. And that looks about right. So this is how you find midpoints in one-dimensional space. Just like you did previously, add the coordinates or add the numbers together and divide by 2. You're taking averages. And just as we went from 2 dimensions down to 1, we can go from 2 dimensions up to 3 and learn how to find midpoints between 2 points in 3-dimensional space. So 3-dimensional space is the usual plane that has an x-axis and a y-axis, but we also have something else, and that is a z-axis that's coming, imagine it coming towards you and away from you. So let's look at 2 points in 3-dimensional space. The point P will be 1, 2, and 3. Those will be its x, y, and z coordinates. So to find that, you can imagine going to the right 1, up 2, and then out 3. So that will give us a point somewhere around here. And work hard to use your imagination to imagine how that point is not on the xy plane itself, but it's actually 3 units closer to you. And the second point we'll be working with has coordinates -2, -4, and 1. So to find this, you can imagine going to the left 2 units, down 4 units, and then out towards us 1 unit. And that would give us something maybe right around here. Once again, work on those 3-dimensional mental muscles of yours. So just as we did in 1 dimensions and 2 dimensions, all we need to do here is to find the midpoint, average the 3 coordinates. That gives us 1 minus 2 over 2, the y coordinates 2 minus 4 over 2, and for the z coordinates we have 3 plus 1 over 2. If we do these calculations, that gives us -1/2, -1, and 2. So this is the midpoint of the points 1, 2, 3, and -2, -4, and 1. And let's kick it up one more notch. We can see 3 dimensions. We live in 3-dimensional space. But imagine we were higher dimensional beings and we went up into hyperspace. In this case, we're going to go and visit 5-dimensional space. I'm not even going to try to draw it because I can't and I don't know how. Let's say the point P has coordinates 1, negative 2, 5, 0, and 3/2. And our second point, Q, has coordinates 5, negative 2, negative 1, negative 3, and 1/3. This is one of the fun things about working with higher dimensions. If you want to work in 20-dimensional space, you can. You just need to make a list of 20 numbers, and those are your 20 coordinates. It's just once we go beyond 3 dimensions, using your geometric intuition becomes a little more challenging. So let's find the midpoint. As before, in all the examples, we're just going to average these coordinates. You could call them X, Y, Z, but then what letters do you want to use beyond that? It's your choice. So we have 1 plus 5 over 2, negative 2 minus 2 over 2, 5 minus 1 over 2, 0 minus 3 over 2, and 3/2 plus 1/3 over 2. So let's now go through and do these calculations. 1 plus 5 over 2 is 6 over 2, which is 3. Negative 2 minus 2 is negative 4. Divided by 2 is negative 2. 5 minus 1 over 2, that's 4 over 2, which is 2. 0 minus 3 divided by 2 is negative 3/2. And 3/2 plus 1/3 over 2 is, I'll do a little quick scratch work up here. So we have 3/2 plus 1/3 using common denominators. That's 9 over 6 plus 2 over 6, which is 11 over 6. If we divide that by 2, it's the same thing as multiplying by 1/2, and that gives us 11 over 12. So in this new dazzling world of 5-dimensional hyperspace, this would be the coordinates of the point that's halfway between P and Q.